There's never a dull moment for barmaid Michelle Connor in Coronation Street tonight. She's left in a lather.
Literally.
When a hunky builder crashes through a window as she's taking a bath. Yeah, just Kim Marsh joins us this morning. Good morning.
Good morning.
It's quite a scene, this.
Yeah, it was. It was quite a scene to film as well.
Penny was worried about how cold you might have got.
Surprisingly, it wasn't that cold. They did fill the bathtub up with really warm water, so it was fine. The trick was trying to keep the bubbles where they were, because they kept kind of dispersing.
That's the problem with bubbles. How long did that take? Was there somebody on bubble watch?
Yeah, there was somebody on bubble watch.
How do you get that job? Because, to be honest, then, there's a few boys here this morning who'd be quite willing to apply.
I don't know, really. It was a woman.
Oh, was it a woman as well? Okay, maybe they've just got the touch. What happens when they show you the script, Kim, and then you read the stage directions in it and it says towel falls to the floor and she stands naked in front of the crew?
You're kind of terrified from the minute you see it, really. Although you're never quite sure, because obviously every director's different, so you don't know how they're going to do it. They might just shoot from the back so that you can't see it. They might just shoot your legs or whatever. But
And you have a modesty pant, don't you?
Oh, yeah. I had big granny knickers on. It wasn't very attractive.
But great fun, nonetheless. And a great scene as well, that sort of a relationship between the two of you as well, because his character is pushing his boundaries and pushing it a bit, isn't he?
Yeah, he is. I mean, in reality, you'd probably get him taken away by the police immediately, you know. But it's a great character, and Kenny's lovely. Kenny Doughty, that plays Jake, is a lovely guy, and really hope that we see him again at some point, because the character was great.
Drop in again.
Yes, as long as I don't have to be naked in front of him again, I don't.
But it's all going great. I mean, and you've been very honest recently about the fact you've had some surgery too, which I imagine sort of gave you a bit more confidence about doing the scene. You've had your breasts done.
Yeah, yes, I have, yeah.
And that was sort of post-children and everything?
You know, it was something I'd talked about. I've never made any bones about it. I've always said it was something that I'd like to have done. So, and obviously then I kind of went into it all properly, because you think it's something you've really got to do. If it's something you're thinking about, you can't just go in and go, right, I'm going to do it, you know. And
because you worry about it going wrong.
Well, yeah, exactly. And, you know, you've got to go to a good firm, really, good company, good clinic.
Good
and
firm.
I went over to Meyer and they just had a look at me and that was that. But, yeah, no, it's given me a lot of confidence.
But is the process quite surreal, though? Because, I mean, you're changing your body shape that you've got very used to and that's happened very naturally as well. You know, what had happened to you was happened as a result with your two gorgeous children.
Yeah. It's, you know, it's just one of those things as a woman, as you know, people always go, oh, would you consider surgery? You go, never say never, because at some point when everything goes south, that's it.
There's a lovely picture of your kids, who I know are watching this morning. Don't you need to say hello?
Yes, I do. Hi, guys. You're probably in bed.
And would they have been interested in any of those toys that we were looking at there?
No, they're a bit old now, really, for them. They're, you know,
computers,
David's nearly
laptops.
15. Yeah, it's all laptops, and Emily wants a pink laptop.
Of course.
Yeah, it has to be pink. Yeah.
Now, I understand that you've been filming a Trevor MacDonald documentary.
Yeah, for The Tonight Show, which will transmit on the 9th of November. We're doing a documentary and kind of investigation into premature babies and premature birth, which is obviously a subject that's very close to my heart.
Are you able to draw on your own experience, of course?
Yeah, absolutely, yeah. And it's been, you know, it's been an amazing kind of, you know, journey, really, doing this filming. And very, very interesting, very sad, obviously. But yeah, so that's quite an interesting programme to
imagine. It was quite therapeutic for you too, to sort of go through the process and to explore what an incredibly moving field it is.
Yeah, no, definitely. And it's nice to think that, you know, maybe doing what we're doing might actually help somebody else. So, you know, that kind of gives me a bit of a boost, really.
Of course.
Yeah.
We were talking just earlier, Penny and I was chatting about the fact that, you know, way, way back, it was when you came to our attention, it was through hearsay, and it was big, you know, the big
reality
show at the time.
The first big reality.
And as it is at the moment with X Factor going on, are you still sort of following X Factor and these sort of shows?
Yeah, I am, actually, yeah. This year's I'm a bit annoyed this year.
About?
I'm a bit annoyed about John and Edward this
year.
Really?